Cefixime is a third-generation cephalosporin used to treat susceptible gram-negative and gram-positive bacterial infections. In this video, let's find found. What is cefixime? What is cefixime used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking cefixime? How does cefixime work? How to use cefixime? What is cefixime? Cefixime, sold under the brand name Suprax among others, is an antibiotic medication used to treat a number of bacterial infections. These infections include otitis media, strep throat, pneumonia, urinary tract infections, gonorrhea, and Lyme disease. For gonorrhea, typically only one dose is required. In the United States, it is a second-line treatment to ceftriaxone for gonorrhea. Cefixime was patented in 1979 and approved for medical use in the United States in 1989. It is on the World Health Organization's list of essential medicines. It is available as a generic medication in the United States. What is cefixime used for? For use in the treatment of the following infections when caused by susceptible strains of the designated microorganisms. 1. Uncomplicated urinary tract infections, caused by Escherichia coli and Proteus mirabilis. 2. Otitis media, caused by Haemophilus influenza, lactamase positive and negative strains, Moraxella catarrhalis, most of which are beta-lactamase positive, and S. pyogenes. 3. Pharyngitis and tonsillitis, caused by S. pyogenes. 4. Acute bronchitis and acute exacerbations of chronic bronchitis caused by Streptococcus pneumoniae and Haemophilus influenza, beta-lactamase positive and negative strains. And 5. Uncomplicated gonorrhea, cervical/urethral, caused by Neisseria gonorrhoeae, penicillinase and non-penicillinase-producing strains. Contraindication. Cefixime is contraindicated in patients with known sensitivity or allergies to cephalosporin class of antibiotics. As cefixime is a third-generation cephalosporin, it is not contraindicated for patients with a true penicillin allergy. Side effects. Adverse drug reactions include diarrhea, dyspepsia, nausea, and vomiting. Hypersensitivity reactions like skin rashes, urticaria, and Stevens-Johnson syndrome have been reported. Though thrombocytopenia has been reported for many cephalosporins, it is reported for cefixime. There is no specific antidote for cefixime overdosage. Gastric lavage may be performed. Dialysis will not remove cefixime in significant quantities. Pharmacodynamic. Cefixime, an antibiotic, is a third-generation cephalosporin like ceftriaxone and cefotaxime. Cefixime is highly stable in the presence of beta-lactamase enzymes. As a result, many organisms resistant to penicillins and some cephalosporins due to presence of beta-lactamases may be susceptible to cefixime. The antibacterial effect of cefixime results from inhibition of mucopeptide synthesis in the bacterial cell wall. Mechanism of action. Like all beta-lactam antibiotics, cefixime binds to specific penicillin-binding proteins, PBPs, located inside the bacterial cell wall, causing the inhibition of the third and last stage of bacterial cell wall synthesis. Cell lysis is then mediated by bacterial cell wall autolytic enzymes such as autolysins. It is possible that cefixime interferes with an autolysin inhibitor. Half-life. 3 to 4 hours, may range up to 9 hours. In severe renal impairment, 5 to 20 milliliters per minute creatinine clearance, the half-life increased to an average of 11.5 hours. Dose. For oral dosage forms, capsules, suspension, chewable tablets, or tablets. For infections. Adults and children older than 12 years of age and weighing more than 50 kilograms, kg, 400 milligrams, mg, once a day or 200 milligrams every hours. Children 6 months to 12 years of age, dose is based on body weight and must be determined by your doctor. The dose is usually 8 milligrams, mg, per kilogram, kg, of body weight per day, taken as a single dose or divided in 2 doses, 4 milligrams per kilogram of body weight every 12 hours. Children up to 6 months of age, use and dose must be determined by your doctor. Safety advice. US FDA pregnancy category B. Animal reproduction studies have failed to demonstrate a risk to the fetus, and there are no adequate and well-controlled studies in pregnant women. Use is recommended only if clearly needed and the benefit outweighs the risk. That's all the information about Cefixime we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video to update more health information.